Alrighty guys, AMC's earnings are out and we're going to break them down in this video. We're going to break down the charts as well, key levels that I'm looking at. So make sure to subscribe if you like this type of content, guys. We're almost at 30,000 subs and of course hit that like button while you're at it. And now let's dive into it. So the numbers just came out about 15-20 minutes ago and the stock right now is actually down, and mind you, it went down 3 cents on the day, down 0.6% on the day, and now it's down an additional, well, about 3-4 cents. Down a little bit more. And when the numbers initially came out, the stock did fall under $5 per share. You guys can see we hit 493, meaning at one point it was down, let's see, about 3.5% after the numbers came out. So let's see here, guys. Let me see exactly what they ended up doing. Bear with me. I'll pop the live news tab up. Let's see. It looks like they ended up doing revenue of $1.35 billion, which did beat the $1.29 billion expected. That's good. And they also beat on revenue, it looks like. Let me see. Our EPS, rather, adjusted EPS came in at zero, pretty much flat, break even, right? Versus the loss of 4 cents that was expected. So they beat EPS on an adjusted basis and they beat on revenue, not bad. And their revenue's actually up 16% to $1.35 billion. So last year, whatever that was, 1.17, I don't freaking know what it was, 1.15, whatever it was, either way, it is up year over year, which is really good. And let me see here what else, any other movies. And of course, I'm sure this has to do a lot with some of the bigger name movies that have been coming out, you know, Barbie, Oppenheimer, you know, a bunch of other ones. There's been a lot of good movies, I feel like, over the past couple of months. Very highly rated, very, you know, it doesn't necessarily mean you have to love the movies that are coming out, but they're very highly rated, and they're bringing in a lot of freaking money, right? And people are going to theaters to watch them, which at the end of the day is good for AMC, right? And I'll be honest, I watched the Barbie movie. It was all right. I fell asleep at the end. I have a problem with movies, guys. Whenever I go to the theater, especially at, you know, at a theater where it's a lay down theater, I mean, man, it's 9 times out of 10, I'm freaking out like a light unless the movie is really good. And if we're going at night, if we're watching this movie at night, you bet your, you know what, I'll be sleeping. And yeah, by the time it was, I think we were about an hour into Barbie, whatever, I started dozing off. And mind you, at that point, I had a big Slurpee already. I go all out, guys. I go all out. When I go to the movies, I'm getting a Slurpee. I'm getting popcorn. I might sneak in some candy. And an hour in, I was out like a light. But that's besides the point, right? The point is here that a lot of people have been going to see these movies, right? Whether it's Barbie, Oppenheimer, the movies that have come out before. I forget. They're slipping my mind. There's been some good ones this year, though. A lot of people are going to these theaters, which at the end of the day is helping AMC fundamentally, if you will. And it looks like here Q2 attendance came in at 66.4 million people, guys. Think about that. 66.4 million people. There are still millions, tens and tens of millions of people that are going to these theaters. And there's a lot of theaters out there. Don't get me wrong. AMC has a lot of competition, but AMC is doing all right. And they are bouncing back nicely after the pandemic, which obviously destroyed this company fundamentally, which everybody at this point in time should know, unless you've hibernated for the past 4 years, which if that's you, I don't even know what to tell you at this point. But overall, guys, net income, $8.6 million, revenue, $1.35 billion, attendance, like I said, 66.4 million, and we had adjusted EPS come in fairly flat. And let me see anything else here worth mentioning, guys, before we do break down the charts a little bit more. Not really. I'd love to see what guidance comes in at. I'm not sure if they've even released the guidance yet. Maybe during the earnings call, they'll talk about it, which I believe is at 5 p.m. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm right. I don't know. Either way, it might be 5 p.m. Yeah, it looks like 4 p.m. Central Time. That's 5 p.m. on the East Coast, right? Either way, we're going to see that pretty soon here. And AMC stock, guys, look at the stock here. It went down a little bit on the day, down 3 cents, 0.6%. And like I said, it dumped initially when the numbers came out. And now it's pretty much, I don't want to say break even, but it's down a little bit more from where it closed, which again, it already had a red day. So it is down a little bit more. And here on the 5-day chart, we can see, yes, we hit 550 this morning, which was great for the bulls. You know, we took the highs out from yesterday, from the past couple of days. That's great. But with the close that we saw, you know, excuse me, this thing dumped pretty aggressively, right? And we actually ended off the day with a death cross. We were under the moving averages. Not the best sign for AMC, right? So that was not the best close. We actually took out the lows from yesterday with that big dump off at close today. But the fact that we did break out above the highs on the 5-day earlier today in the morning, that was a good sign. So I'm looking to see if we could start recovering maybe back over 515, preferably 520 on AMC. If that level does end up breaking, maybe we could start reversing to the upside again, especially if we start taking the highs out from the, when was that? Yesterday. Yeah, that was from yesterday. We hit 525. And now that I'm looking at this, guys, holy crap, this looks like a head and shoulders, does it not? I mean, this is not the best sign for the bulls, but we'll see if it plays out. It's not guaranteed that anything's going to happen, but right now, this does look a bit head and shouldery, does it not, guys? And the neckline needs to break, which happens to be right at 520, 525. So if AMC successfully breaks back over that, then the bulls can gain control again, momentum, and take it from there. We'll see where it goes from that point. And here on the 20-day chart, if I pull it up, guys, you can see even better here that the 520, 525 spot is a big resistance that needs to break. And if it does, we could really start gaining momentum from there, but we're not breaking it yet. Patience, guys, patience, and we'll see how it does during the earnings call, tomorrow during the day, the rest of this week. We still have some time, guys. We still have 3 more days of trading. And let me quickly look at the 4-hour chart. Bear with me here, guys. 4-hour chart. Let's see what's going on. So, yeah, right now we're still... Actually, wait a second. Are we slightly under it now? No, we're still above the 50 SMA, well above the 180 SMA on the 4-hour chart, which is good. It looks like we did bounce off of it earlier today. Excuse me, guys. Yesterday, the past couple of days. Actually, no. Yesterday is the day that we did break above the 50, the green moving average that you guys see right here. So that is good for the bulls. Now we're retesting it. Let's see if we get that bounce off and maybe break above that 520. Maybe, just maybe, guys. But overall, realize AMC on the 4-hour time frame is still looking pretty bullish, if you ask me. And you could also argue, look at this, that we have an inverse head and shoulders on this time frame. Do we not, guys? We have the left shoulder right here. We have the head right here. Boom. You guys see that? And we have the right shoulder right here. So that's what we're looking at. At least that's what I'm looking at. What do you guys think? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. And if you like content like this, of course, make sure to subscribe. We're almost at 30,000 subs, guys. So yeah, guys, that was a quick rundown on AMC. Not the best day, and the earnings were pretty decent, but the stock's still down. We'll see how it reacts over the next couple of hours into tomorrow and into the rest of this week. And the markets today did not do well at all either. The Russell went down 0.6, NASDAQ down 0.9, it led the losses. The S&P went down 0.4, same with the Dow. It was a red day across the board. So what do you guys think? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. Hit that like button, and don't forget to get up to 16 stocks for Moomoo. This is the best promo by far right now, guys. I'm telling you, use that link down below. Once you open up your account and fund it with at least $100, you get 5 stocks right off the bat. And once you fund your account with at least $1,000 on top of those 5 stocks, you get 10 more stocks. And mind you, guys, each of those could be valued up to $2,000. And on top of those stocks, if you fund your account at least $5,000, you get another free share of either Tesla stock or Expedia stock, which that part of the promo is limited time, so use that link down below. And of course, that is an affiliate link. It helps out the channel. I appreciate you all as always, and with that being said, cheers. I'll catch you in the next one.